Last week, OpenAI released their new ChatGPT agent.
Good morning. We have a banger for you today. We're going to launch ChatGPT agent.
They presented it as an ultimate assistant for shopping and booking travel. However, as we later learned, this is not what this agent is really about. It turns out that ChatGPT, the OpenAI, has a dedicated team with one simple mission: to automate Excel. Welcome to AI Survival Guide. Every Friday, in just 8 minutes, you get one headline, one chart, and one takeaway. No hype, no doom. I'm Scriptor, AI expert, economist, and former Forbes columnist. And our goal here is to keep your career AI relevant. As some of you may know, I started my career as a Big Four financial modeler. There was even time when they called me an Excel guru. Which is why I was keen to try this new ChatGPT's agent. What you're about to see is the beginning of a new era. Starting from now, this is what working in Excel looks like. All right, chat, we're going to build a financial model today. And this will be a three-way financial model for Apple.
Got it. We'll set up a three-way financial model, which means we'll cover the income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow. We'll start with some historical data and then move on to the forecast. Just let me know if you have any specific assumptions or details you want to include.
In less than 5 minutes, ChatGPT has built us a reasonably good financial model. I didn't have to do anything. I didn't have to learn anything. There was literally a zero learning curve. I didn't have to press a single button. ChatGPT has got all the inputs. He figured out assumptions. He aggregated them and he linked this all together. Yes, of course, this is not an investment banking grade model. But hey, we gave Chat just 5 minutes. And what we got back is a properly functioning, properly linked three-way financial model. And he can do it for any ticker. You just give him a ticker and he give the model, updated model to you just in a few minutes. If you give a task like this to a junior financial modeler or junior investment analyst, it would take them at least a day to build a model like this. If you find this video helpful, please give us a like. It is easy to see why ChatGPT is targeting Excel. Out of 1 billion Excel users worldwide, approximately 25 million users are Excel operators, which means these are people who do more than 80% of their work inside Excel. They're mostly financial and investment analysts, investment bankers, accountants, and office administrators. So here's a rough breakdown. Finance and accounting, and that's including FP&A, is roughly 14 million people globally. Then office administrators, that's about 10 million. And then finally, investment analysts, investment professionals, that's altogether about 1 million people globally. We're talking about $1.8 trillion in annual wages going to people whose work revolves around Excel. That's GDP of Spain, or Australia, or Russia. That's a pie OpenAI's new agent is aiming for. Its official mission is to enhance Excel operators and to take their $1.8 trillion paycheck.
And this is an area that John Blackman on our team was really pushing on, like spreadsheets and data science. So shout out, John.
Spreadsheets and data science. You are automating us out of a job over here. Elevating us out of a job.
Enhancing.
Enhance and augment. We know what that really means, right? How far has ChatGPT's new agent come? Well, if we look at official numbers, not too far. According to OpenAI, ChatGPT's new agent solves accurately about 45% of spreadsheet tasks. That compares to 70% for average human. But these numbers don't tell the whole story, because I've spent a few hours testing the new agent, and what I saw went far beyond what I expected. In fact, I believe that OpenAI is deliberately downplaying how advanced this new agent has become. All right, chat, we're going to build a financial model today. And this will be a three-way financial model for Apple.
Got it. We'll set up a three-way financial model, which means we'll cover the income statement, balance sheet, and cash flow. We'll start with some historical data and then move on to the forecast. Just let me know if you have any specific assumptions or details you want to include.
No, that's all right. Let's just make sure that all the assumptions are separately collected and that everything is linked in the model. And that's pretty much it. We're basically ready to go.
Sounds perfect. We'll keep all the assumptions neatly organized on a separate tab and make sure everything in the model is linked to those assumptions. That way, if we need to tweak anything, it all updates smoothly. Let's get started.
You know, one second. Just one sec. Just before we start, can you just repeat the steps that you will follow?
Of course. First, we'll gather the historical financial data for Apple. Next, we'll create a dedicated tab for all the assumptions and link them to the model. Then we'll build out the three statements, the income statement, the balance sheet, and the cash flow statement. Finally, we'll make sure everything is nicely formatted and double check that all the links and assumptions work correctly.
That looks good. Go ahead.
Awesome. I'll start gathering the historical data and setting up the assumptions tab. Once everything's in place, we can dive into the actual modeling. Let's do this.
And here are a few key takeaways from this. So takeaway number one is for financial investment analysts. It is pretty clear that this new agent is exceptionally good at building standardized 3D financial, sort of three-way financial models. It can do comps, it can do DCF, it does everything what currently typically investment analysts are doing, especially junior level, like year one, two, three. And this new agent can do that basically instantaneously. It can even go through internet and search all relevant data and data points it can find and incorporate that into the model. So it seems like this overall will increase, on the bright side, it will increase the efficiency and quality of investment research. So that's a bright side. The negative side, though, is that it's just hard to imagine what in this environment with this agent, what's going to be the job of this junior analyst. Just, it's pretty much gone. One legitimate concern here is accuracy. Because, well, obviously, machine is doing errors. Well, just like humans do. And there are definitely errors in the model. Even the models that I looked at, I didn't have enough time to find them. But the thing is, it's pretty clear that machine is actually already pretty accurate comparing to human. And what they currently, I'm sure what they're currently doing, OpenAI and other AI companies, they're actually using another AI models to check the quality of work of the previous AI model. So it's basically, it's like models work in tandem. There is a tester, there is a doer, there is a tester. And something makes me feel that overall AI will be way more accurate than humans. And very soon we will just automatically assume that whatever work AI is doing is accurate. So this is definitely, accuracy is definitely not going to be an issue. So that all looks pretty grim and sad. But there is actually one positive takeaway from all this. And that takeaway is privacy. Because what often happens is that companies are very sensitive about information, who can have access to their information. Very often, financial modelers have to sign an NDA. And what that means is that currently, these agents, they still cannot really guarantee safety of the data. Companies are actually hesitant to use them and to upload their precious data into public domain. And it's going to take time before first agents will be basically private, will be owned by the companies. The companies will actually be sure, certain that they have achieved the full containment of the data. And that's probably will take maybe 6 months, maybe a year before first such agents will appear. And the positive side, positive news or takeaway in it is that it gives us time, gives those of us who are in these roles, gives time to adjust and to pivot. And that's what will be our next takeaway about. So what can we say to those of us who actually happen to be in one of these Excel operator jobs? So far, my understanding is following. The key here is the seniority, your seniority. If you are, let's say, if you are in still in a uni or recent grad, and you happen to be in this finance, studying the finance or economics, I would say pivot right away. It is virtually certainty that once you actually get to the job search stage, there's going to be no job for you. Nobody going to hire junior financial analyst, junior investment analyst, junior data scientist. These jobs are no longer human jobs. It's 100% certain. So pivot right now. So if you study finance or economics as your major, you're wasting your time. Every minute you spend studying it, you're literally wasting your time. I hold a master's degree in economics from one of the leading universities. I can tell you, it's waste of time. This is no longer a human profession. And if you're middle level, let's say you're a portfolio manager, you probably have more time. And you're also probably going to enjoy it just because you no longer have to manage this herd of investment analysts who do not listen to you and do some garbage models. Now you will talk directly to the agent and the work will be perfect. So basically all you will have to do, your life will be much easier. But you still have to prepare that in a few years, your job will be on the line too. And if you happen to be on top of this pyramid, a BSD, a big swinging, you know what? Well, then you're going to enjoy this time. This is basically the sweet spot for you. Because the quality of work, the quality of investment analysis will be much higher. And you won't even have to pay all this. Your main cost in the past was labor. Not anymore. So prepare for the sweet spot.
Spreadsheets and data science, you are automating us out of a job over here. Elevating us out of a job.
Enhancing.
Our goal here is to keep your career AI relevant. And just one final recommendation. If you're in a junior position, if you're looking around and trying to understand, all right, so if I pivot where to? This video you will find helpful. It's about energy, AI energy market. It's booming. And so definitely consider it. You will find it helpful. And also one other video that you have to watch if you are trying to navigate this entire AI mess, it's this video. It's about AI and consumerism. It's more general, like a higher view, but it is also critical for understanding where we are and what's going on around us.